Hello and welcome to episode 12 of Football Tactics and Glory, the Walsall career mode. Right, today we're listening to some Kevin Wilson, so enjoy the video and enjoy the music.
Thank you very much. Mega Fugly's hand. Sheila's, you know, they didn't have a fanny between their legs, they'd have a fucking bounty on their head. You know, the ones that... She's a super mega fugly with a moldy mango twist. Complexion like a pizza with warts and moles and zits. And just to even say her name, you've got to be a fist. Cause she's a super mega fugly with a moldy mango twist. When she was born, the doctor slapped her mother in the mouth. And when they brought her home, they wouldn't let her in the house. And as she grew, it's sad to say, she just grew uglier. They tied some snags around her neck so the dog would play with her. Before she went to school each day, they had to iron her face. She'd get the cuts for coming early and merit points for coming late. And they had a portrait painted in 6 different shades of shit, cause she's a super mega fugly with a mouldy mung bean twist. She's a super mega fugly with a mouldy mung bean twist. Including her own mum and dad, she's never yet been kissed. And just to even say her name, you gotta be half pissed, cause she's a super mega fugly with a mouldy mung bean twist. When she puts on a lipstick, it keeps backing down the tube. And I've woke up screaming, dreaming that I'd seen her in the nude. When she sits on the beach, the tide's just writing to come in. A sperm whale tried to root her last time she went for a swim. If they made an ugly meter, she'd blow the thing to bits. Under grotesque in the dictionary, there's a photo of her tits. And if I ever cracked a fat for her, I'd amputate me dick, cause she's a super mega fugly with a busted arsehole twist. She's a super mega fugly with a busted arsehole twist. Hell's Angels wouldn't root her, said they're not that fucking sick. So she bought herself a dildo, but she couldn't keep it stiff, cause she's a super mega fugly with a busted arsehole twist. She's a super mega fugly. Oh God, she's fucking ugly. She's a super mega fugly with a hanging hemorrhoid twist.
Sounds woggy already, doesn't it?
Spiros and Athena, they met at the village fair. He was bald as bowling ball and she was thick with hair. He won ribbons for his prize goats. First year that he win, she won his heart when she picked up them goats and carried them home for him. They both got drunk on ouzo, she said yes when he proposed. Now he finally get to fuck a woman instead of fucking goat. And Athena's getting her badge waxed for the wedding. Special gift for Spiros when needing those wedding bells. Athena's getting a badge waxed for the wedding. And her monobrow, her mustache back and butt crack waxed as well. Athena had a young sister named Katrina, she was hot. Sexy, slim and beautiful, all things Athena's not. One week before the wedding, when Spiros make a call, he parked his bicycle against the fence and knocked upon the door. Young Katrina answered naked, he could not believe his luck. She smiled at him seductively, all he could say was,
"Fuck! Holy bloody fuck!"
Then she whispered,
"Oh."
Cause Athena's getting her badge waxed for the wedding. Special gift for Spiros when needing those wedding bells. Athena's getting her badge waxed for the wedding. and her monobrow, her mustache, peck and butt crack whacked as well. But Theodore spun around and started running towards the gate, when Athena's mum and dad popped up, shouting,
"Spiros, wait!
Young Katrina was just testing you, and now we know for sure you're the special man our family want to be our son-in-law." Again he wiped his brow and thought, "How lucky can I be? I was running to get condoms in beneath bicycle seat." You clap hands for this bit while Athena's getting her badge whacked for the wedding. Special gift for Spiros when needing those wedding bells. Athena's getting a badge whack for the wedding, and her monobrow, her mustache, back and butt crack whack as well. And her monobrow, her mustache, back and butt crack whack as well.
Hey! If it's political, it ain't correct. Those two words don't fucking fit. So I wrote a little PC pushback song that I'd love for you to sing while we flip them PC pricks the finger singing F-U-P-C. Fuck you, political correctness, F-U-P-C. You're crippling free thinking and you're strangling free speech. The world's flipping you the finger, don't give a rat's ass. Break my bones, but words can never hurt. Armed with that and a dilly-gap attitude, my world just seemed to work. But them precious PC snowflakes take offense to everything we say. Millennial dyslexics, they read everything round the wrong fucking way. So I say, fuck you, political correctness, F-U-P-C. You crippling free thinking and you strangling free speech. The world's flipping you the finger, don't give a rat's ass what you think. Fuck you, political correctness, F-U-P-C. Flip and sing. Fuck you, political correctness, F-U-P-C. Where's all this PC bullshit coming from? What happened to common sense? Trying to convince us now you can pick up a dog shit by the cleanest end. Don't want us to have an opinion. Can't say now what you see. You know what I see? A bunch of fragile, soft-cock fucktards. F-U-P-C.
Fuck you, political correctness, F-U-P-C.
You're crippling free thinking and you're strangling free speech. The world's flipping you the finger. Don't give a rat's ass what you think. So fuck you, political correctness. F-U-P-C. Flip them one for their dog.
Fuck you, political correctness, F-U-P-C.
One for the horse they rode in on.
Fuck you, political correctness, F-U-P-C.
That'd like to think that if I could go back in time, Banjo and Henry and even Ned Kelly would all be good mates of mine. Because they're pisspots, poets and outlaws, and I can relate to that. And I can relate to their attitude too, in a word, dillygaff. That's spelled D-I-L-L-I-G-A-F, dillygaff. And this is what it means. You
I look like I give a fuck? Dilly gaff. Am I being direct enough? Dilly gaff. It's just another way of saying I couldn't give a fucking rat's ass, mate. And do I look like I give a fuck? Dilly gaff. Your turn.
Do I look like I give a fuck? Dilly gaff.
You see, it's stress relief made easy. It's simple and it works. Just say dilly gaff next time you gotta deal with dickheads, wankers and jerks. And when you go out, stick a dilly gaff on your t-shirt or your hat. And when some cunt's giving you the shits, just say, mate, read that. That spells D-I-L-L-I-G-A-F, dilly gaff.
Do I look like I give a fuck, dilly gaff? Am I being direct enough, dilly gaff?
Just another way of saying I couldn't give a fucking rat's ass, mate.
Do I look like I give a fuck, dilly gaff?
Your turn.
Do I look like I give a fuck, dilly gaff?
Do it again.
Do I look like I give a fuck, dilly gaff?
Am I politically correct enough,
dilly gaff?
Just another way of saying I couldn't give a rodent's rectum, mate. And do I look like I give a fuck, dilly gaff? Your turn.
Do I look like I give a fuck, dilly gaff?
Big finish.
Do I look like I give a fuck, dilly gaff? Common sense ain't that common anymore. Seems common sense is past tense, just like the dinosaur. Political correctness has got a lot to answer for, 'cause common sense ain't that common anymore. Political correctness, what a crock of shit. If it's political, it ain't correct. Those two words don't fucking fit. Nor do military intelligence, friendly fire and holy war. But common sense ain't that common anymore. Words made up by academic fuckwits who hide in little fart-filled rooms, throwing random words together 'cause they got fuck all else to do. Starts out as yuppie jargon, ends up fucking law. 'Cause common sense ain't that common anymore. Common sense ain't that common anymore. Seems common sense is past tense, just like the dinosaur. Political correctness has got a lot to answer for, 'cause common sense ain't that common anymore. Words like illegal immigrant, is that a fucked up double or what? If you're an immigrant, g'day and welcome. If you're illegal, fuck off. And who's them low-life tow rags letting them sneak through our back door? 'Cause common sense ain't that common anymore. Racist, there's one overused word that's laced with toxic venom, spat out by every do-gooder and minority group when you don't agree with them. Mate, this is Australia. One size fits all, but common sense ain't that common anymore. Common sense ain't that common anymore. Seems common sense is past tense, just like the dinosaur. Political correctness has got a lot to answer for, 'cause common sense ain't that common anymore. Petty crime, there's no such thing. Some poor bastard's gotta pay. Here's two words that just might work. Rattan cane. We don't need a fucking police service. Bring back the police force, 'cause common sense ain't that common anymore. So all you soft-cock politicians, try getting your head around this. You're fucking up a great country, and we're tired of that PC shit. Try using a little more common sense. That's what we're paying you for. But common sense ain't that common anymore. Common sense ain't that common anymore. Seems common sense is past tense, just like the dinosaur. Political correctness has got a lot to answer for, 'cause common sense ain't that common anymore. Common sense ain't that common anymore. No, common sense ain't that common anymore.
Met him in the classroom back in 1963. We seemed to hit off pretty good. We were mates, Mick and me. He wasn't such a big kid even back then at the start, and he wasn't all that clever either, but Jesus, he could fart. I first found that out in class one day when things were going pretty slow, and just to keep us all amused, Mick let this fucking river go. You should have been there. Look, I'd describe it if I could. But I just turned around and I said, hey, Mick, you're fucking good. And at the inter-school grand final on the rugby field that time, we were getting beaten. They were 12 and we were 9, and play was 3 yards from our goal line when the referee called a scrum. And Mick said, don't worry, fellas, we've as good as got it won. So we just locked ourselves down in the scrum and we held each other's nose. And Mick, our little hooker, he let this fucking river go. It stung their nose and it burnt their eyes and it even scorched the grass. And I twigged right then and there, he had a double jointed ass. Mick, me made the master farter. Put the art back into farting with his custom tailored farts. Mick, me made the master farter. Broke new ground in breaking wind with his double jointed ass. And it was just a couple of years later, we both went to see Kamal. It was a really poshy sort of show in this great big bloody hall. And all the blokes were dressed like penguins. And you should have seen the sorts. And Kamal himself wore a Sheila's dress like a bloody black boy George. And we were all locked in there like sardines for the show to get underway. But the tuba player didn't lob. He'd booked off crook that day and Kamal said,
without a tuba player, I cannot commence the show.
So old Mick jumps up, said, Sambo, mate, I'll have a fucking go. Well, from then on in, I honestly thought that the whole show would be ruined. But he just winked at me and picked that tuba up just like he knew what he was doing. Then the maestro tapped his little stick to tell the band to start. Mick just shut his eyes and cocked his leg and then began to fart. Well, you could have heard a pin drop that night there in the hall. And it's hard to say who sounded best, Mick farting or Kamal. Then the audience just went apeshit. They cheered and clapped and stood. And Kamal smiled as if to say,
hey, Mick, you're fucking good.
Mick, me mate the master farter. Yard back into farting with his custom tailored farts. Me mate the master farter. With his true pitch perfect calibrated double jointed ass. Well, good news travels fast, it seems, and it wasn't very long before Mick got this midnight phone call from Ben Lexon and Alan Bond. They said, Mick, we got this specialist job and we're prepared to pay ya. Mick, old son, would you consider farting for Australia? We'll just prop you on our brand new yacht when there's no sea breeze blowing and get Mick the master farter, the starter, and keep the bastard going. So Mick went into training on sausage rolls and pies and Vegemite and Foster's beer and a scholarship from Heinz.
Right, I'm going to end this video here. I'm going to say thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe, share, hit the bell for notifications. And there will be more Football Tactics and Glory tomorrow. And until then, I'll see you all again. Goodbye.